Today on Pricklist, I present to you an upgrade consisting of over 900 pieces for the 10332. I'm probably not the only one who loved the return of the medieval series, starting with the medieval blacksmith, followed by the Lion's Knight castle. Now with the addition of the 10332 medieval town square set, I think it's appropriate to give more attention to this series. So today, I present to you the upgrade consisting of 985 pieces by mock designer Easy Pricks, which connects the houses of the carpenter, weaver, and the farmhouse by building a city wall with a watchtower, giving them much more prominence. Furthermore, an area has been created to connect the loose buildings, thus creating a proper town square. I purchased the 985 extra pieces on Pricklink for around $110. The instructions cost an additional $8.50. Let's start building now. First, we lay down some plates and build the foundation of the first house, where we place both a wood lathe and a chair. Then we continue with the construction of the city wall. Next, we furnish the house with a door and nice details such as this bow and a shield. Above the door, we place a door arch, then use the first sticker for the carpentry sign. We continue with the foundation, raising it up, adding a nice stone pattern outside the entrance and adding two torches. A small awning is attached to the side of the house. The city wall is then completed and topped with battlements. Additionally, we place the first two minifigures of the set. Next, we move on to the cheesemaker's house. For this, we place another large plate next to the previous ones and start with the foundation of the house. The floor is built with various gray colored pieces in a checkerboard pattern. Then we raise the walls and place both an oven and two tables covered with cheese inside the house. We fill the two gaps with doors and a chair next to them. A very nice detail is this cat that finds its place on the kitchen floor. We equip the kitchen with cooking pots and the cat gets a bowl of milk. We then turn back to the construction of the house wall and add some nice details like this window frame with a flower or the cheesemaker's sign. Now that the interior of the cheese dairy is finished, we just need to complete the foundation and then place the roof on top. Around the cheese dairy, we built a small stable which is protected by a fence on the outside. As nice details, we add a squirrel and this water bucket for the little goat. The roof is now decorated with more straw and hay elements. The carpentry also gets a second floor, where we also cover the roof with more hay elements and hide two black stones on the outer wall with two lion knight shields. We then build the last part of the city wall. I fast forwarded a little here as the construction is quite repetitive. You can tell me if you prefer these detailed and slower construction shots or if you prefer it when I show the construction only roughly. In this part, the city wall is also equipped with a tower where we attach two lion knight flags. Now we place the city wall on the rest and attach the plate with green pieces to the cheese dairy module. The last house in the series is the weaver's house. The first step of the construction is to build a first row of foundation consisting of black pieces, followed by the floor pattern. We continue with the wall consisting of black and white pieces. Inside we place some spools of colored yarn, a few kitchen utensils, and finally the loom with a nice tapestry. The house is then equipped with a door and completed with the construction of the remaining foundation and the roof. Outside we then built a nice garden where various crops grow. We place the house next to the other houses using Technic pins. After we finish building the first houses, the instructions from Easy Pricks instruct us to continue with the Lego instructions to build the Broken Axes Inn and the Watchtower. Then we continue with constructing the marketplace. For this, we build a large green platform where a small water area finds its place. Then we build a large tree which is adorned with some stickers on the trunk. After attaching all the branches and leaves of the tree, we continue with covering the square. First we place a small fountain, then a vegetable stand, in the middle a sawhorse with an axe, the little boy with his cheese stand, the tax collector, two more pieces of furniture, and finally the painter with her signs. That's it for the construction. This is what it all looks like together. Now I want to introduce the buildings to you again in more detail, starting with the connection of the houses along with the city wall. The houses are now separated from each other and independent, unlike in the original set, and a new city wall with a watchtower has been built, which runs through the row of houses. Let's start with the outermost house. This is the Weaver's house. It is characterized by its black and white walls and a very sturdy roof with a nice window. As mentioned before, it is now completely independent and modular. On the front yard we find a nice garden with a mix of various plants to harvest and even a beehive. To access the interior we can open half of the house by pulling on this black piece or simply peek through the front door. Inside we find the paradise for any weaver. Not only does he have his own loom here with even a work in progress, but also a selection of spools with colored yarn. Furthermore, the weaver has a small oven and fireplace that heats the house. The house is attached to the carpenter's house using technic pins, and on the backside we find a small gate that blocks the passage from behind for intruders. Now let's move on to the carpenter's house. Firstly, the roof has been improved by adding some hay elements, which were forgotten in the parts list at the time of recording, so I'll show you the picture from the instructions. This makes the roof sturdier and more realistic for the medieval period. The blue awning has been moved from the back to the side since the carpentry is now integrated into the city wall and closed from behind. However, it can be opened again using this black piece to look inside from behind. On the side of the upper floors, two lionite shields have been added to hide these, let's call them ugly black parts, which I really like. Otherwise, the upper floor inside remains completely identical. Let's continue with the city wall and the cheesemaker's house. Between the carpentry and the cheesemaker's house, a small courtyard has now been created by the new city wall, which clearly separates the two houses from each other and makes the whole village appear much larger. On this courtyard, there's not only plenty of space to play, but also some nice details hidden, among them this target or this barrel with arrow and quiver. You can either go to the carpentry through the opening in the wall or up to the city wall via the stairs. The city wall runs through the cheesemaker's house and hides a large watchtower at the end. This watchtower is equipped with several flags, to be precise, 3, and can be accessed via the stairs behind the gate made of spears. On the backside of the city wall, we also find several firmly rooted plants. In the middle of the wall is the cheesemaker's house, which is even signposted. Around the little house there's a stable delineated by a fence. Inside the stable we find a water bucket for the goat, through which we can infer where all the cheese comes from. Additionally, a small rodent has snuck in. The roof of the house has also been covered with more straw and hay parts, and it can be easily removed to access the interior. Here you'll find exactly what you would expect from a cheesemaker. The interior is also identical to that of the original set. The only other change you can find in the house is the integration into the city wall and the function of opening the city wall to get better access. The building with the broken access in and the watchtower remains unchanged, except for this little tree here. The last expansion of the set is the new town square that connects all the loose buildings we got in the original set and turns them into a town square. This consists of a large green area where, among other things, the large tree from the Lego set, which has been expanded again, finds its place, along with a little water puddle, a new fountain with a water bucket, a sawhorse in the middle of the green area, the stand where the painter paints her shields, both tables of the carpenter, a new vegetable stand, and next to it the cheesemaker's stand. What do you think of the now consisting of 4,300 piece medieval village? Let me know in the comments down below. Shout out to EasyPricks for creating this breathtaking upgrade. In my opinion, this upgrade consisting of only 985 parts is exactly what the set needed. Because at first glance, I wasn't particularly impressed by the set, because it just seemed a little bit too small for my liking. Now with the new expansion and the added city wall and each of the houses being separated from each other, I think it looks much more lively and looks much more like a medieval village. I'll link you the mock as always in the video's description. That's it for today on Pricklist. See you next week with another exciting model. Bye guys.